Alright, so moving on to a new Mario DS hack. This one is New Super Hacker Bros. I already did a walkthrough of this, but that was nothing compared to this version. First of all, you can see the title screen has been changed. But you can't really change the storyline, so that wasn't changed yet. But the title screen was changed, and a lot of other things were changed. The music was changed, and there's, you know, the new tile sets and everything. It's a completely new hack, so I just decided to pretty much do it again. Anyways, if you looked at the old version of the hack that I'm LPing right now, it's up on my channel already, all the parts that are available so far. You know, it doesn't even go up to the final castle in World 1, so it's a really short hack. It was a really early version, and I downloaded it from their site. You know, I'm just like, oh, I found a hack, let's play it. Because there's not a lot of DS hacks out there, so once I get one, I'm just gonna bake it till it's deep fried. So, first thing you can see is the first level is a bit changed. You can see the music and everything's different. Instead of vines, you get little ladders. And I find the idea of them being vines better, but it shows that they changed the tile sets by showing ladders instead. Up here used to be the first Star Queen, but they replaced it with a pipe and a minigame. So, I already saw what happens when you push the X button. If you push that button over there, it pretty much cracks the whole floor and you fall through. Alright, let's get off the topic of Mario. If you looked in the beginning of the video, you would notice there was a Machinima intro. No, not the intro that's on Machinima's channel, but an intro that included Machinima's logo. And if you looked at my channel, you notice it's partnered and everything. You put all the ideas together, you realize I'm a Machinima partner, so thanks a lot for that. And I'm actually partnered on all three channels. I'm just... even the network channel. So on the... on Tyranitar Tube and Tyranitar Tube Global, I'm partnered. And the weird thing is, on the Global channel, I was partnered when I had zero subscribers. And it's not even YouTube partnership, it's a gaming partnership. On the network partnership, I have been approved for YouTube partnership, but I still haven't accepted it because I'm waiting for a good time to accept it. Although, it would probably be better to accept it now, but who cares? It's my decision, so shut up, you bum. Well, I'm not really angry, don't get the wrong idea, but, you know, I just have nothing to talk about. I bet you I'm gonna say partnership, the word partnership, like 1,000 times in this video, so be prepared for that. If anyone does want partnership for themselves, like, your own channel's getting partnered, I can hook you up with pretty much any partnership. No, I don't work for any of them, but I can really help you out, me being a partner. I'm partnered with a lot of companies. But I left a lot of companies as well, so it's probably gonna be hard. I don't know, but like one of them is Machinima partnership. So if you guys want help, I can probably hook you up. I sound like some drug dealer, but all I have to do is go to my Tyranitar Tube Global channel. If you become a director and I like your content, I can give you a partnership. I helped Jeremiah and Isaiah get partnership. And I helped a few other people get partnerships. So there you go. I'm helping multi Pokemon World, and I'm gonna try getting Jeremiah to make a video proving that I got him partnership, just so I can, you know, get a service for him. Because, you know, there's so many people who deserve partnership but they don't get it, which really sucks. So I'm gonna actually help a lot, because I mean, I don't know if I deserve a partnership because it's my channel, so I'm not sure whether I would deserve it or not. I make videos good enough that if anyone else posted them, I would watch it. And check it out, it's a green mushroom, green flower. Oh, green flames. That's sweet. That's pretty sweet. And then my old method of getting that Star Queen. So yeah, fudge. So if anyone does want a partnership, go become a director for the Global channel. You'll like it. Aw, man, can you hear that? Someone's calling me on Skype. This sucks. Who cares? I'm just gonna keep playing. Oh yeah, I find it pretty annoying when I'm doing my... I'm working on a video, and then all the time I hear the calling noise, or I just keep hearing that message noise, just like, yo, shut up, I'm making a video. But, well, it's not their fault, you know. Like, after I tell them making a video, they shut up, but yeah. Best thing to do is just block them or move them after you're done making the video. Send them, let them become a friend again. But anyways, this level reminded me of, what is this reminding me of? This reminded me of Super Mario Bros. 2, the fake one. fake Mario 2. I don't know why. Maybe because there's, oh my god. Maybe because there's falling platforms. There's no falling platforms. I don't know. Why is this reminding me of fake Mario 2? I don't know. Well, there we go. 5 minutes taken off just to beat level 1 to 1. Yeah, so I had like 20 things to talk about in this video. And all 20 of them were, you know, just pointing at partnership. And right when I say partnership, all 20 ideas are gone. So I'm like, I'm speechless. I have nothing to talk about. But anyways, for those of you who are like, what, partnership is useless. Like, I don't want to get paid. I just want to be just the guy who makes videos. I don't need the brownie options or anything. But partnership actually improves your YouTube thing. Because I, like, before I used to get, like, what, 5 subscribers a day. That's a lot. Hey, look, it's a nice flower. What the hell? But anyways, like, I used to get 5 subscribers, but now I'm getting 20 subscribers a day. So people say, you know, he's a partner. He must make good. That is. Gee. People say, you know, he's a partner, so it's kind of obvious that he's a good guy. Like, before people, if they see you're not a partner, they don't know how to judge you. But if they're a partner, they know, okay, Machinima likes him. We could like him too. It's like, I don't know. It's just how people do. They go with the crowd. It's like, if someone buys juice, everyone will buy that exact same juice. Well, that's how it is in my school. I don't know about you guys. No one's gonna go ahead, you know, I don't like that juice, I'm buying a different one. No, because they want to go with the flow. If everyone buys an iPhone and they have the option of getting an Android, a BlackBerry, or an iPhone, they're gonna get an iPhone because they want to go with the flow. That's just how it is. So if they want to go with what other people think, so they're gonna just subscribe and stuff. And yeah, it's pretty sick. Also, sub for sub does not help. The only thing it does is, well, it can help sometimes, but most likely doesn't help. The other day, Onish Pranks released a video where they're pranking a guy who's a musician. He was an okay freestyler rapper and stuff, but he's not the best. He was okay, not the best. I think I just said that. But when he was pranking him, he looked at all the details that he obtained, and he realized that he does sub for sub, and he mentioned it in the video. So he got about 4,000 subscribers because he was promoted in the video. But he also got a lot of hate saying, you do sub for sub, that's useless, this and that. And people unsubscribe, they do dish that. In the future, everyone's going to know you used to do sub for sub. So no matter, even if you're number one subscribed, you have 1 million more subscribers than William Johnson. People are going to know you're fake. So don't sub for sub. And if you do, do it secretly. But still, don't even do it secretly. Just don't do it. What the heck? It's like don't smoke if you are gonna do it secretly. That's not gonna help. Yeah, just don't do sub for sub. Box for box is okay, but because you're not really doing it, you're just boxing someone to help them get promoted, and on the way you're promoting other people yourself. This is a confusing place. I think I broke the level. Oh, orange coins. Fudge. Yeah. What the heck am I supposed to be doing? Whatever. And yeah, so just don't do those stuff. If you are doing like a gaming channel, go with new games because most people will watch it. Go for stuff that a lot of people are looking for. If a lot of people are looking for Modern Warfare 3 gameplay, go do some Modern Warfare 3 gameplay. Don't go and do Modern Warfare 1, Call of Duty 4, because if it's not highly anticipated, then no one's gonna want to watch it. In addition, if you're not a gaming channeler, then do a series that you specialize in. I specialized in Fanimation Fun Boxings and a lot of other series, and it became popular because no one does it, and it's my own creation. So yeah, like, if there's people who start their own series on YouTube as well. You don't have to be the only one who does it. So yeah, just keep that in mind. See? This is the new version of the hack, and they actually fixed the old problems where you couldn't get the Star Coin before, and now what the fudge? But now, you couldn't get the Star Coin before, and now you can, so, oh god, okay. So now you can get the Star Coin, so, yeah, that's one thing I'm doing. That's why I'm redoing this LP, whatever. It looks good. It looks like a new hack, so that's why I'm just gonna do it again. And one thing is, always appreciate feedback, And if someone hates, don't go back. Don't go starting like, oh, you mad, bro, dish dad, I shoot you in the face, your mama. Don't do any of that, because that brings hate. And when other people say, see, you're a hater to a hater, then they're going to be like, what the heck? You don't deserve the stuff that you do. You don't deserve all the subscribers. But yeah, so far, this hack is really interesting. It's got a lot of cool things. Look at this. A changed tile sets. Fire flowers are still there. Now we got like red, green flame flowers, and I guess you can say blue flame rather than ice flowers. But you get variety of texture hacks, so you get different flowers, you get new tile sets, new levels, new songs, new dish, new deck. Everything's amazing in this hack. So yeah, so far this is the best hack I've ever played. Behind this would be Super Mario Bros. 3, mainly because, well, this one ties with Super Mario Bros. 3. My bad, not Super Mario Bros. 3, but New Super Mario Bros. 3, which is another hack that I did. But I didn't commentate in that hack because, you know, I was afraid. Alright, you know what? You see all the stuff I was talking about? Take that. You see that window beside you? Throw it out there. Like, why am I talking about what to do on your YouTube channel on a Mario video? Like, that's stupid. Like, that's stupid. It's not anything I said was wrong or incorrect or misleading. It's correct, but it's just like, why in this video? Holy kabloom, look at this place. Everything's great. I can't get any coins. Can't hit the blocks, I bet. And I can't go in here. Yeah, I can't go in there. But the door's color, that's interesting. Alright, let's put it as that. That's interesting. It's probably a mini mushroom, which definitely is. This is gonna be the hardest part. Not the hardest part, it's gonna be a hard part. I have to concentrate. Bam! Smack each other in the head. Flip. Jump, flip, bang. Jump, flip, bang. How the heck does he do that in mid-air? Don't fall, good. How the heck does he flip in mid-air and then fall on someone? Alright. What would you do if someone in their inventory takes out a mushroom? What would you do? They should put this on the bottom screen. I guess that's the only point of putting stuff on the bottom screen is so you can't use the inventory items. But no, they don't think of budging that. Oh man, I think I'm gonna have to exit the level. I can't exit, I didn't beat it yet, no! Alright, I'm jumping on you. I'm gonna fly, jump on, oh yeah. Look at Mini Shy Guys! Holy kabloom, Mini, how, oh my god. Holy Shy Guys, but those guys are having a lot of fun. Hope you don't make any babies, man. Man, yo. Alright, never mind. So, there's this cool iPhone application. Give me that life, Toads, Green Toad Head. I was playing this application on the iPhone, but I have an iPod Touch. And I have an iPhone, but it's a 2G, so yeah, you're not gonna. I'm just gonna keep that a secret. I don't know why I told you. I have to put that out of the video if I remember. At least I have an iPhone. Some of you guys have Nokia phones, but Nokia phones are like solid, they never break. iPhones, you drop them and the touch stops working and all you have is a phone without the touch. An iPhone without the touch. That's like, I don't even know, I'm not gonna say that's dirty. But, oh, you see the glitch. See, this is an iPhone app called Tilt-A-Lip. And this app, jump! Oh yeah, what's up here? Nothing. So this iPhone app, why'd they put the hole in it? This iPhone app is really addicting, and you have to pretty much tilt to get these items and everything. You should go watch it on YouTube. At first, it seems like, what the heck, this is a boring app. You're just living to tilt and blah, blah, blah. And then, like, I found it boring in the beginning, and now I find it super fun. Definitely check it out, because it's amazing. So, yeah, we're in 14 minutes into the video. It's done. So, you know, I'm gonna cut the video right here, so I'll see you guys in part 2 of this. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this, and what else am I supposed to say? Right when I'm done this, I'm gonna go play Tilt-A-Lip, because it's fun. I play it more than my DS, so it's like, what the fudge?